Good day to everyone. Today, we are going to continue in our topic in HTML. Now, we have lesson 4, dealing with form elements. At the end of the lesson, students shall be able to define different form elements, different types of input elements, different input elements in a form, test if a form passes data through the get or post method, and develop forms with multiple elements. Now we start in form elements. The HTML forms use different elements to accommodate different ways of inputting in a form. To create a form element, first we need to use the main tag, which is the form tag. And inside the form tag, that's where we put other form elements like input, buttons. In our main tag, the form tag, we use two attributes. First, the method. Second is the action. When we are using method attribute, there is always two values that we need to remember. First, the post. Next, the get. The get method transfers data to the URL, while the post method transfers data using HTTP, or we called hypertext transfer protocol, or the secured method. I mean, not really the secured, the hidden method, as you can say that. The get method is used when we are creating a search engine or a simple text transfer in a form. But in post, we use post in registration form and in login form. The method post is used to hide the data that can be vulnerable or can be stolen by other users. So always remember, there are two methods to remember if you are creating a search engine or a simple form data form transfer. We use a get method, and in a secure way, some secure way, we use a post method, for example in login form and registration form. Next attribute, we have action. Action holds the URL where the data will be transferred or will be sent. And we have the simple syntax of a form tag that contains action and method attributes. Now we have form elements. First, input, label, select, text area, button, field set, and legend. Input elements set different input methods from a simple text field, an email text field, color picker, or a button. While label only displays text for form elements. Label is used to put a text that represents an input element or an element inside a form. Select element is used to create combo boxes, a drop-down list of choices in which the only one may be selected. Text area is a multi-line input where you can insert a paragraph as an input. Then we have buttons. Buttons are clickable elements. These are best used together with JavaScript. So when it comes to JavaScript, we are going to encounter that in Unit 3 of this lesson, of this topic. Last, we have the field set and legends. Field set tag defines a group of interrelated contents, while legend tag displays the field set's title. Now, these are the six basic form elements we can use inside the form tag. We have the example of a text box where we used input element or input tag. As you can see, we created a label for the input tag, where inside the label tag we use four attribute. This four attribute, it represents the value equal to the ID attribute of an input element or input tag. For example, we have the value equal to name. As you can see, the ID attribute of input is equal to name. Then in the input tag, we use the type attribute to identify what type of input we are going to use. And here we use text. And we have the name attribute to represent the name of the input. As I said before, in label tags, we use four attribute to determine which element uses that label. Bear in mind that the value equated with four attribute is the other element's ID, as you can see in the previous example, where the value of ID attribute of input is equal to the value of the four attribute of label. Then we have the select tag. Select tag always contains option tag that used to list down the values or the selections where the users can choose inside the select tag. And we have the example of a select tag where we have the name attribute as its name and the ID attribute as its identity used for labeling. Then inside the select tag, we have two options or two user options. The first one is we have the BSIT, and the second one is BLIS. As you can see, the second one is the default selected in the select tag. Using selected attribute, you can automatically display what is the default selected in the options. And using value attribute of in option tag, we can identify what value will be sent as data. by the form. Now we have text area. Text area tag size is defined using the calls and rows attribute. You can adjust the text area by the calls and rows. And as you can see the example below, we adjusted the calls of the text area in 30 and its rows in 5. We also have the example of button here where the button contains the type attribute to identify that it is a button and an on-click attribute to identify the command used in JavaScript. So we used alert function here to display hello as a JavaScript command. That once you can click the click me button, it will display a pop-up that displays a hello text with the OK button. We also have field set that makes it easier to see interrelated contents as it groups the form elements. And we have the example here where we group some form elements such as student number, first name, middle name, and last name. Also the submit button of the form or a sample form. And as you can see, using the field set, it will enclose all the elements inside it in a margin. And using legend, we can set the field set title, and we have the student information as the field set's title here. Now we have different types of input. Using type attribute in input tag, we can identify what type of input we are going to use. For example, we have a text that accepts any characters as an input, and we have password that mask the user input. It is mask the user input by as default asterisk, or in other web browse, in other browsers it masks in a bullet or dots. We also have the submit. It is the input tag will be displayed as a button that is intended to submit input or users inputted data of the form. Then we have the reset that resets the contents of the form to its default values. We also have radio. Radio button is used to permit users to choose one from many options. It's like a round, it's like a circle. Once you click, it will be, it will display a selected as a dotted circle. And we have the checkbox that allows users to select more than one of the available options. It will be displayed as a square, as an unclick or unselected, and a square with check if it is selected. We also have color, which we use to create a color picker. Then we have date that will create a an input box with the date window once clicked. And we have the email that accepts only email formats. We have file, that allows to select and send a file to the server. We have range that sets the input tag into a slider that allows the user to select a value from a given range. We also have search. It is like an ordinary text box, but it has an X button that allows the user to clear the value to be selected. And we also have the number that only accepts numbers in users. And we have the example here of what the input elements looks like. We have A in email, B in passwords, C in ordinary text, D in date, E in a radio, and F in input file. We have two buttons below, which is G that represents submit and reset. It is the sample user interface in an empty output. And we have the example of filled out output of the previous elements. As you can see, we have the email, and the input always accepts in email format. And we have passwords that masks any text we type in dots or asterisk. We have ordinary text. We have a birthday. We have gender, where we we used radio as an input type. And we have input type is equal to file, and we have the reset and button. Then we have another input elements, such as A for search, B for checkbox, C for color picker, D for range, and we have E for number. And we have the filled out output of input elements on search, where once we type any text, it will show a, it will display an X button on the right part of the input box, where we can clear the text we entered. And we have the checkbox, where we can choose multiple we can choose more than one, like blue, gray, red, and green. We have the color picker. Once we click the input box of a color picker, it will display a window where we can select colors or specific color. We have range of blue, gray, red, 5, from 1 to 5, and we have the text box equal we have the input input tag, and type is equal to number, where we use in age that only accepts numbers, and we have the submit button. And that's all we have in lesson 4. Now for the test, or to test yourself if you learned something, there are questions here, like number 1, which is more appropriate to use when allowing the user to select only one option. Is it the radio button or the combo box, and why? The number 2, why do you think it's best to include the accept attribute in an input type file? Then last we have, when used in rating, e.g. rating something from 1 to 5, which is the best type to be used? Is it range, number, or radio? And why? Now, these are the questions to test yourself if you learned something in our lesson 4 of HTML.